Okay, and then my next step is to install in here these camshafts back, and it is easy to remember that that area is exhaust cam, because in here we can see those dusty exhaust manifold, these holes, and in that area we install this exhaust camshaft, and then of course this area is intake camshaft. And then I need to install also this camshaft, these heads, these covers and these cups, what are in here, these holders. And now we can see that one is in here position, but I need to install now all of these valve covers in here back. And remember that each of these valves, these covers, they are unique. They have this certain amount. And let's go to look that when I install in here those next valve covers. Okay, and here we can see that I have made in here these markings. This is like exhaust one. And then I have also clean cotton cloth. And remember to clean both areas, also this inner area, that area. And there we can see also those markings. And there is marking 56 in here. And it means that this is, what is this thickness of that valve lifter. And now I clean that, and then this is this exhaust one position. And now when I install these just in same positions, then this my valve clearance is okay. And then I have also in here exhaust two, and let's check that what is number. And there is 44 in this inner areas. And that means that this is thinner valve lifter than that one. But this is okay, because this lifter belongs just in this position, and that part, it has been installed in here when this Toyota factory has been made that engine. Good. And now they are in good position, and then I install all of these valve lifters, and of course I need clean cotton cloth, and I need to clean all of these parts really carefully, that there is no any oily or no any sand or no any dust in here. And remember, this cleaning is mandatory and musting. And next I take more of these valve lifter, what are these valve caps in here, these covers. Okay, and then I take my next, there is exhaust, and this is dirty, and I clean also all areas carefully. And this is exhaust 3, this sign, and there is number 43. Really interesting, 43 in there inside. Okay, and that one belongs in here. And then I take exhaust 4, and let's check like in informative thing, and what is inside. There is 46 this thickness. Very interesting. And when we know these numbers, we can later adjust this valve clearance so that we purchase new of these cups and these valve lifters, because there we can purchase all of these numbers in Toyota dealership center. These are like spare parts. And then exhaust 5. And interesting thing, what is number? There is 50 in inside. 50. We can see that there is 50 number in there. Okay, interesting. And then cleaning. And we can, and this part belongs in there. Good. And then I have exhaust 6. And there's a little bit 30s, and an informative thing, there is 37. Interesting, 37. And this is very thin valve lifter cap. Interesting. And I installed that in here. This is okay, good. And then I continue that my job, and when all of these valve lifters are in position, we can continue. Okay, and now I have installed all of these, and this is final one, intake 8. And let's look like informative, and there is 49 is this thickness in their sign in here. And this one belongs in here, good. In this final area, and now it goes nicely, good. And now when all valve lifters are in position, next one is that I can install these camshafts in these positions. Okay, and here is really this exhaust camshaft, and how we can know that this is exhaust camshaft, because there is no this valve VVT-i system in this exhaust area, only in this intake area. And of course it is good to clean this camshaft also carefully, that there is no any dirties. Looks good. Okay, and now it's in position, excellent. And there is then this intake camshaft. And I check also that it is okay. And in that sign we have these VVT-i sensors, these pins in here. And there is this sensor, it is in that area inside. Okay, and then I clean these cam bearings. Good. And now this cam is okay, and then I install these camshaft bearings. Then one important thing, there is this first camshaft's bearing plate, and I have to install this one in here. And now I move that, and this belongs in that area in here. Good. Now it's like position. It is like bearing plate in this intake cam area. And then I start to install this camshaft bearing covers, and in Toyota engineering these parts goes only in here in one way. And it is easy to check that when I rotate that this part belongs in this position, excellent. And then that exhaust cam's first bearing cap goes only in one way in here. And this is nice Toyota's engineering, excellent. And then I take next bearing caps. Okay, and here are this my next one, and there are these markings, and there is this mark that like X2, and this one, and also arrow, and this arrow means that now I have to install this my bearing cap in that direction, where is this timing chain. And this bearing cap is number 2 is in here, and then number 3 looks good, an arrow, and this belongs in that one, good. And then I take next bearing, and then I take this my next one, and this is exhaust 4, and this belongs in here. And then final one is exhaust 5. And I clean both sides. And then I check those arrows. All are towards that area. Good. Okay, and then I take this intake, camshaft bearings, and there is intake 2, and it belongs in that position. And then intake 3, and arrows, and then next one, intake 4, and final one is intake 5. Looks good. An arrow is in that way. Good. And now all of these cams bearings are in positions. Okay, and now when all of these cams are in position, next step is in my job list that I need to rotate all of these bolts in, like, using my fingers so long then they rotate and moves. This is like first step. And after that I need my specific tool, this torch French tool. And let's look that when I have rotate all of these bolts and these bearings in end, we can then continue that my job. Okay, and then I need this my torque French tool, and this is 10 millimeter socket, and now this force is 10 newton meters for these small 10 millimeter bolts, and then 30 millimeter for these 12 millimeter bigger bolts. And I start this my cam, this togue, in this line 2, like in central area, and little by little, so long that we can hear this sound. Now it is 10. Okay, now these are in okay, and then I go in little bit in that area, in here, and I next I took with this one in here, and this 10 newton meters, it is very small amount of that force, because this my tool says that right away that now there is 10, and then I go in these bolts, and then there is 10, good, and then in that area. Okay, and there is, okay, good. And now these, that cam, these intake cams bearings are okay, and then I go in that exhaust cam. And let's look. Okay, good. And then that one. And this is okay. And then in here. This is very sensitive thing. And then that one. And 10 newton meters. Good. And then these big bolts in here, it was 30. Then I need 12 millimeter socket. And also I need to set up this my torque reference now to 30 newton meters. Good, and then set. And now we have in 30 newton meters in there this force. Excellent. And then I start this my job, and in here, that one, and soon this my tool clicks, That is 30. 30. And then in that area, and in this one, 6. And now all of these bolts, they are fine, and then it is good to rotate a little bit these cams and do this pre-check, because now there is risk that some of these can be loosened, and next I take my wrench. And then I need this 24 millimeter wrench, and I can install this my wrench in here, and now I can rotate this my cams a little bit in that way, like one rotation, that how they moves. Okay, and now, and then that one, and then if you notice that these cams, if they don't move, then there is thing that valves takes contact to these pistons in here, and that's no any force if we notice that there is contact. But now I can feel that this moves good, and then I have to soon do so that I have to set up these cams and also these pistons, because now I can feel that pistons takes contact to these valves, and this is very bad situation if engine is running, but in this setup process we can set up these all parts. Okay, good. And now I will do this camshafts valve bearings, these bearing caps pre-check. I take my top reference tool and I check again that what is this. Now I am checking that firstly these bolts, that they are 30. Let's look. Good, this is right. This is right. And then that one. And that one. All of these bolts are fine. And then I check all of these smaller bearing caps togues, that they are fine. And then I check, and I have set that 10 newton meters this force. 10 newton meters. And let's check that what is this bearing cap status. Okay, this is fine. That one is also. That one. Good. And then that one. This is okay. Okay. And carefully. And that one carefully. Good. Everything looks fine. No any extra force. Looks good. And then these final parts, they are fine. Okay. Good. And now all of these camshafts, bearings, covers and caps are in position, and that area is ready. And next I need to rotate these my cams and also these my crankshaft in here, so that they are just in right positions, because next I need to install in here this timing chain, and that's all of these parts must be in just right position. And now I need to install this my engine in this TDC position, and that means that all of these parts are in right positions when I install this timing chain. And let's go to do that job next.